I would like to I would like to introduce an old colleague and friend, Miriam Henkens, who is the International Medical Coordinator at Medicine Sans Frontières, and who has been working for a while on a lot of outbreaks, and especially cholera outbreaks. Mimi, I would like to ask you to comment on the role that surveillance plays in operationalizing cholera as a cholera roadmap in the MSF activities, actions, not only the responses, but all the actions regarding the cholera. Mimi, the floor is yours.
Merci, Marc. Merci pour cette introduction aussi.
Thank you, Marc. Thank you for this lovely introduction.
From international perspective, but also with a very operational perspective in mind. If you look at the global cholera roadmap, it is focusing on three strategic axes. First, the early detection and quick response to contain outbreaks. Then a targeted multi-sectoral approach to prevent cholera recurrence, and then an effective mechanism of coordination for technical support, advocacy, resource mobilization, and partnership at local and global level. Clearly, surveillance is needed for these three axes. First, surveillance is based on diagnostic confirmation. And while this can be done in laboratory, we'll still need fully quality assured, therefore WHO pre-qualified, rapid diagnostic tests. Moreover, those tests need to be available, affordable, and have characteristics that allow them to be stored and used in real field conditions. This will allow for better decentralized cholera confirmation and complement the role of more centralized lab-based diagnostic. Having a rapid diagnostic test will also permit timely detection of outbreak and facilitate a timely response, as the ICG mechanism can then be triggered. The ICG mechanism is there to improve and accelerate the delivery of vaccine and their integration into a comprehensive response to help containing each outbreak as soon as possible. The decision to allocate vaccines when supply are limited depends on the characteristic of each outbreak, but also of the risk of spreading. And this risk analysis is based on surveillance data from the event, but also from historical surveillance data, among other elements, such as population displacement, occurrence of the rainy season, etc., etc. Moving to this strategic axe number two, surveillance is also key to identify the hotspot where cholera cases are seen regularly. And in some of those areas, the hotspots are the source of regular extension to larger cities. Surveillance is therefore needed to prioritize the intervention based on the needs and including the geographical location identification. Surveillance is needed to quantify the needs, and also surveillance is needed as the basis for additional analysis to decide the best adapted intervention and balance the different complementary elements of the response, such as responding to the wash needs, vaccination, community engagement, case management, etc. Surveillance will also be mandatory as the basis to set priority when we are facing competing needs. And this is part of the third strategic axe, the coordination mechanism. To best use the best use of the available resources, such as vaccines or finance, is key for ending cholera. And last but not least, surveillance is key to measure the impact of this global strategy. It is necessary to assess the global or country impact, but also to measure the impact of the different interventions implemented in different countries or circumstances. Successful intervention can therefore be replicated accordingly. And this all will finally contribute to the concrete path toward a world in which cholera is no longer a public health threat. Thank you.